Hello everyone, I'm excited to be here to show you how you can secure data processing with AMD Confidential VMs on Azure Databricks. My name is Lasse Jenzen, and I'm a principal consultant at ORAYLIS, a Germany-based IT consultancy with more than 20 years of experience in data platforms and in reporting. Our passion is to turn your data into value. As Microsoft and Databricks partners, we are more than happy to share the following agenda with you guys. Let's start. First, I'm going to tell you how cloud adoption faces regulatory challenges within the European economic area. Secondly, we will see how confidential computing acts as a real cloud enabler in this area. Third, Databricks. Databricks accommodates those confidential computing features, delivering business value through its data intelligence platform. And all of that is in theory. So I brought you a reference architecture, live demo, and customer testimonial. Last but not least, let's have a quick look on strong partners that unlock confidential computing within your organization. Let's not waste time and start with the first topic. Cloud adoption faces regulatory challenges. And as I said, we are an IT consultancy based in Germany. So most of our customers are located within the European economic area. Thus, specific protection rules apply on personal and sensitive data, so-called GDPR, General Data Protection Regulations. And when customers want to adopt a cloud, our first question is, where is the cloud, so the hyperscaler, located? And if we talk about Microsoft, that is within US. So there is the potential risk of data transfers outside the EEA to USA. So, and that is a problem for regulated industries. For example, credit institutes, mobile companies, or insurances. Well, until 2020, organizations could rely on the Privacy Shield framework. But since 2020, the European Court of Justice judged with Schrems II that organizations can no longer rely on this framework. Instead, they must implement additional safeguards, such as end-to-end encryption, to protect sensitive customer data. Well, how to continue? Confidential computing really acts like a cloud enabler here and gives you additional safeguards. Within Azure, there's already two existing encryption methods. Data at rest on the one hand, which encrypts interactive data when stored on blob databases or managed disks. Secondly, data in transit, which encrypts data when it is flowing within internal or public networks. Thanks to the collaboration between AMD and Microsoft, there now exists confidential computing that encrypts data in use, including cryptographic keys. And that basically protects against malicious, privileged admins or insiders using a trusted execution environment. Even Microsoft, as cloud operator, is not able to see unencrypted customer data. Secondly, hackers that are trying to exploit bugs in the hypervisor or operating system. And last but not least, it also protects against third parties that are trying to access data without customer consent. Well, that sounds like a lot, but how is it working? Within Databricks, we are making use of AMD's secure encrypted virtualization technology, in short, SEV-SNP. And that has three main features that I really like. First of all, hardware root of trust, meaning within the CPU, there are built-in security features that ensure the integrity of computing operations, protecting against unauthorized changes, and providing a secure foundation for trusted software execution. Secondly, remote attestation. That means there's the chance to verify the security of a remote computing environment by proving its configuration. And last but not least, memory encryption. That means your data is saved within the computer memory by encryption when you read it or write it. If you want to learn more about confidential computing and how is it implemented, just follow this QR code and learn more about it from Microsoft, Databricks, and AMD directly. So let's talk about business value creation with Azure Databricks. Azure Databricks data intelligence platform delivers business value to over 9,000 customers worldwide by enabling the functionality to build cloud native lakehouses. So let's jump into that. What is Azure Databricks? So Azure Databricks is built upon an open data lake. In terms of Microsoft Azure, this is Azure Data Lake Gen 2. And there you can cost efficiently and robustly save your data, whether it being structured data like tables, semi-structured data like JSON files, or last but not least, unstructured data like images, videos, and so on. On top of that data lake, Delta Lake was built by Databricks to provide a unified data storage for reliability and sharing. Usually, I explain this like a transaction log for data, meaning you can robustly insert, update, or delete data records. On top of that, Databricks built the Unity Catalog, which provides unified security, governance, and cataloging for your data. Well, don't drown in your data, find it again. Basically, that's Unity Catalog. Databricks is also based on the open source technology Apache Spark, which is able to efficiently compute big data workloads. Together with the data intelligence engine, you can choose various tools to compute your analytical workloads, whether it being Databricks AI, Delta Live Tables, Workflows, or Databricks SQL, there is something for everyone. So that is the data intelligence platform. And as I earlier said, this now includes confidential computing, meaning it makes it interesting to use for regulated industries like credit institutes, like insurances, or mobile carriers. Now you can implement various use cases based on sensitive personal data, like targeted marketing, risk assessment, fraud detection, personalization, and last but not least, service quality improvement. Well, let's dig into how to actually set up Databricks, including confidential computing, with a reference architecture. Let's assume you have an on-premise system and Azure set up. On-premises, you do have sensitive data and users that are trying to build analytical workloads or to build reports, for example. First, set up a VPN. Then establish a site-to-site connection to Azure by configuring a VPN gateway, properly configured firewalls, and last but not least, virtual networks. Please refer to the Azure Landing Zone concept and the hub and spoke topology to properly set that up. Now let's dig into our data architecture. First, set up an Azure Data Lake Gen 2, where we can efficiently and robustly store our regular data in the Delta Lake format. As I said, transaction log for data. On the other hand, we will require Azure Databricks confidential computing clusters. And there, we compute our data before storing it onto the Azure Data Lake Gen 2. And that consists of two main components, confidential VMs and managed disks. Confidential VMs are secured by AMD's SEV-SNP technology. Managed disks, on the other hand, need to be safeguarded using managed HSMs. Why? Because managed disks may contain spilled data from Apache Spark for intermediate computation results. Managed HSM, that is something like the Fort Knox for your keys. There you can safely generate and store keys to encrypt the managed disks, as I said, check mark. And secondly, to implement in-app encryption for sensitive data on Azure Data Lake Gen 2. Why is that? Well, Azure Data Lake Gen 2 is not a confidential service. So there's the potential risks of hackers to access the data. So by implementing this in-app encryption, we can secure this data before it reaches Azure Data Lake Gen 2. And that can be all done using Delta Lake by encrypting the affected columns. After we have now seen the architecture, let's dive into the live demo and see how that works. I've prepared a resource group in Azure with two main components, Azure Databricks on the one hand and an Azure Data Lake Gen 2 on the other hand. Please ensure that you set up four mandatory settings in Azure Databricks. That is first, VNet injection for data plane. Secondly, private link for control plane. Third, security and compliance features to comply to GDPR. And last but not least, please enable encryption of managed disks using a managed HSM, as I said earlier. So let's jump into the demo. Here you can see we have a confidential computing demo notebook. But before we open that up, let's review our cluster. I have configured a sample cluster using 14.3 LTS runtime in Databricks. In this cluster, you can see that I have configured confidential computing machines. You can see it there, DC8AS V5. And that is already confidential computing, as I said. This exists in two flavors. On the one hand, general purpose and memory optimized. Depending on your use case, you might select smaller or bigger machines. And if you're required, also select memory optimized. But let's cancel this window as my cluster is already correctly configured and up and running. Let's jump into the demo. First, I'm going to create this new schema called Confidential on the Azure Data Lake Gen 2. Secondly, I will create a Delta Lake table for our customer data. Here, we will store encrypted data with columns person ID, first name, last name, religion ID, which is quite a sensitive information, health insurance number, and last but not least, credit card number. Afterwards, I'm implementing two functionalities as user-defined functions. First, a UDF to encrypt confidential data, and a UDF to decrypt it afterwards. Please be reminded, here I'm taking a plain text AES key. In your production environment, please ensure to adopt a proper key management system. So let's continue. Now the UDFs are registered, and I can continue to generate sample sensitive data for five customers. Here you can see every column is filled with sensitive information, and I can continue to encrypt that information properly before I save it on Azure Data Lake Gen 2. Well, let's do that now in the next step. Here, I'm using my user-defined function. And as you can see, every column is encrypted using the AES algorithm and safe to be stored finally on the Azure Data Lake Gen 2. Let's do that in the next step. One click, and we insert the customer data into the customer table. We use our user-defined function, and we can see that five records have been just inserted into our table. Now, when an analyst wants to use the data and to do further data processing, we just leverage the decrypt functionality in order to decrypt the first and the last name. And as you can see, all other columns are basically still encrypted at rest and secured against malicious third parties. So, what do customers say about this solution? Our customer, Telefonica Germany, is saying that Azure Databricks Confidential Computing is their first choice for the robust protection of sensitive customer data. It ensures data privacy and ownership throughout the large-scale data analysis, unlocking significant business value at Telefonica Germany. So, what's next? You can trust on strong partners to unlock confidential computing within your organization. That is Microsoft with its trusted secure cloud, AMD with best-in-class performance based on confidential computing, Databricks with one data and AI platform, and last but not least, well, there's us, your data and AI platform enabler. Our passion is to turn your data into value. And if you want to learn more, just follow our QR code and browse through our wiki. Thank you all for being here. I hope you learned a lot. See you soon next time.